pray, what wayward spirit beckons? I shall name you Foundling, and you may call me Sesta Janessa. You're uninitiated in the Raphaid's mysteries, I see. What a curiosity you are, wearing a man like a shell. You've awakened him, but you know nothing of him yet. Fetch me one of his mementos, and some tar too, and I'm sure we can stir up some recollections. Of course, first you must find his name.
Devout, their allegiances lie to those who are fata, or spirits. They entertain themselves with drunken antics or violent cruelties. They know better than to attack us. But they followed us at a distance, hoping for scraps.
by false truths. Unfortunately, I have little to offer you, save for that tarnished seal in your hands. A small gift, but I expect you will find it useful. Would you grant me another favor? Deep within the temples of the devout, you'll find the sacred glands of the revered. Bring the glands back to me, so I can extract the true nectar. Just enough to heal me. Perhaps you too can use it to free yourself from this wretched land, before you end up like me.
Gentlemen, certainly not one of those boorish fanatics. Welcome then, I'll warm some tea. In the meantime, why not take a look at my wares? Surely there's something you'll fancy amongst my collection.
Thank you.
The entrance is not far, foundling. But you may regret trespassing. I speak not only of my brothers and sisters, but of their twins. Just as every flame casts a shadow, so too does the spirit. And here they manifest. Reflections, birthed from a broken mirror, a shattered place. Best not to burden yourself with such thoughts. tip this and you'll see.
Thank you.
You've kept me waiting, foundling. Do not worry. 'Tis only a jest. This path ahead is littered with monuments to suffering. Thought I might lighten the mood. Not that I've ever had much talent for humor. I once knew a man who took the sacrament of ashes. He laughed all the time. Now I'm rambling like an old crone. You're here for another sin, aren't you? Don't overindulge. Eager for another taste, foundling. Not so hasty. Not all places are as friendly as Fulcrum. There won't be any merriment around a bonfire here. Only the dead call this place home. All that remains are scavengers gnawing on bones. An intruder like yourself will not be welcome. So then, would you like another sip?
They foretold a truth more terrifying than any other. Those who glimpse it behold no monster other than an utter lack of meaning. The visage of a razor-thin line between existence and non-existence, and nothing in between.
Thank you.
extended friend. Shall we engage in some rousing commerce? I'll gladly accept any tar as payment.
is my turn to rest, to finally sleep without dreams.
Yes, slowly now. Sip this and you'll see. Worship unfettered, enshrined in ice. Can you blame them? The perversity of living has always been its ever-changing nature. So, then, would you like another sip?
Creatures grew soft and flesh-like, wrinkled like my own hands. They blossomed into something strange yet familiar. Had sent me. Of course, she was unimpressed until I led her to the exquisite, impossible creature. How could it be anything other than divine? She worshipped at its feet, and our bargain was struck. She would burrow into the bowels of Earth and await deliverance.
Oh.
feel them. The enshrined wait, watching the Immaculate for thousands of years. They will not stir until the Ascension. They wait for her to deliver them. Here, drink fully. Warm your bones.
Thank you.
truly your blessed foundling. That gland contains the true nectar, the most precious sacrament. Each drop holds both transcendence and transfigurement. Rare is the soul brave enough to extract such an offering. I'm afraid I'm no longer fit for such work. The rite of extraction requires deeply pious hands, though perhaps deeply blasphemous hands would do. Yes, taste the... Thank you.
friend. Shall we engage in some rousing commerce? Surely there's something you'll fancy amongst my collection.
Oh.
Yes, taste the truth.
I had not anticipated the architect's success. Clamoring throngs demanded entry into this impossible temple. I pushed through them, finding him now clad in garish vestments. Crimson dribbled down his chin as he drank from an ornate chalice. I confronted him, but the mob would not allow me to lift a hand against the source of the nectar.
Sip this.
Thank you.
You look parched, foundling. Curious how even a creature like yourself must endure the indignities such as with the sacred ashes. Sip this. Is a tainted vessel fraught with impurities. I do not miss it. Well, perhaps I do miss one or two pleasures. I once thought we were alike, these disciples and I. Consecrated by ragged edge and raging flames, they seek only to be one with their own God. I pray that you do not find yourself upon the pyre. Sip this, and you'll see.
I found it.
Yes, taste. Your triumph is nothing short of miraculous, foundling. That sacred gland in your hands holds the purest sacrament. The true nectar inside is not meant for you or I. And yet, it is all we hunger for. Whether lost or devout, such a rare gift arouses covetous desire. Remain wary and keep it close. this and your signal.
Thank you.
Yes, taste them. this, and you'll stop. Don't worry. It is not your mind unraveling, but our world. Our senses betray us. My... Sip this, and you'll see.
Surely, such creatures have been sent to us for some greater purpose. Their secret bodies adapt to our world with startling speed. And somehow, I feel I've changed too. Yet, I see the terror in the eyes of my kin. They do not understand this blessed harmony. They only understand subjugation and slavery.
Yes, slowly now. Thank you. Once I was in awe of the knowledge contained here. But it was a fool's errand to try to catalog the contents of this library. The devout keep searching, endlessly hunting for a revelation. Even as they're surrounded by madness. Keep your eyes ahead, family. Do not stray among the teetering stacks. You'll only delay the inevitable. Yes, you've done it. The sacred gland is yours. Perhaps it was always yours. If you manage to extract the true nectar, be wary. Sip slowly. I remember a heretic who drank deeply. He took what wasn't his and gulped it down greedily. He was unrecognizable afterward. Another man entirely. This was his reward and his penance. This place is teeming with madmen who drank until they drown their senses. sip this and you'll see.
Dulled and softened. But I know these lies.